Hi, this is Scott Tagawa. I am the medical director of the Genitourinary Cancer Program at Weill Cornell Medicine. Today I'm going to talk about monoclonal antibodies, which are proteins that are involved in the immune system that essentially act as keys that will only recognize very specific locks. When these are introduced in the body, they will target only those very specific locks which happen to be on cancer cells. In addition to monoclonal antibodies acting on their own, we can also attach something specific to it, like a drug which can hitch a ride into the cancer cell. So rather than administering a drug that goes everywhere in the body, it will go only directly into the cancer cell. We have already started using this technology today, so in the clinic we are able to take either a molecular imaging agent or a drug into patients today. At Weill Cornell Medicine, we can exploit the specific properties of monoclonal antibodies. This figure demonstrates a man's bone scan. Areas that are darker are abnormal. As you can see here, some of the dark areas in the spine and the pelvis represent tumors, but there are other areas of darkening that are abnormal that are nonspecific. For instance, in the elbows and the wrists, those areas of darkness represent arthritis. When we deliver a monoclonal antibody, as can be seen in this animation, initially it travels throughout the body looking for the specific cancer cells. It then enters via the key and lock system and winds up only in the areas of tumors, skipping over the nonspecific areas such as arthritis, as can be seen side by side in this bone scan and picture of the tumors. Radioimmunotherapy involves the practice of attaching a radioactive isotope onto a monoclonal antibody, using the immune system to take that radioisotope into a cell. We can utilize different properties of different radioisotopes. For example, lutetium-177, or 177Lu, is a short-range isotope that is effective in small tumors. In comparison, yttrium-90, or Y90, is a longer-range isotope that may be better for bigger tumors. However, if utilized in a small tumor, there is extra radiation that then might damage normal tissues. At Weill Cornell, we are able to utilize many different types of radioisotopes and can exploit each individual isotope's properties, thereby delivering the right treatment to the right patient at the right time.